Hello everyone, I hope that you are all fine and welcome to the For The Craft channel. In this video I created my own version of the Skull Island, but I made it very tiny. Obviously I needed a human skull, so after I printed one with my 3D printer, I started making the island with polymer clay. I flattened the top of the skull and after I baked the polymer clay, I glued the parts. Of course I had to blend the parts together and for this purpose I used epoxy clay. Once everything was hard and dry, I started the painting process. First I covered everything with a black acrylic color, which would highlight all the details and the shadows of the rock formations. Then I used various shades of brown and grey colors, and I gave the surface a heavy dry brushing with a light grey color. On the underwater part of the island I created some turf and seaweed, and used PVA glue and natural sand to create the island's small lake and beach. Also, I sprayed with isopropyl alcohol to make sure that the sand will stick in place. When I was making all this, I thought to myself how cool would it be to have a guardian to protect this island? And how cooler would it be to make a huge octopus coming out from one of the skull's eyes? So I made an octopus from polymer clay and painted it with a toothpick. I also wanted to make a couple of whales swimming around the island, so I made them from polymer clay and used the thin fishing line to hang them in their place. When everything was ready, it was time for the resin pouring. Now, guys, as you noticed with the octopus, sometimes ideas come in my mind whilst I'm working on a project. So at this stage I had the crazy idea to create very tiny palm trees for the island. In order to create the trunk of the palm trees, I used a natural fiber rope and extracted some tiny fibers, which I then made firm with wood glue. Then I used the green crafting paper and this special tool to cut the leaves of the palm trees. When I made enough trunks and leaves, I started making the palm trees. I added a drop of wood glue on the top of the trunk, and slowly I started attaching each leaf until I had a fully completed palm tree. As you can understand, this process took me a lot of time because I had to make 60 trees. Once the trees were ready, I started creating the landscape by adding some grass and also by gluing the palm trees in their place. Thank you. then it was time to create the waterfall. I made the waterfall with UV resin. And used UV resin again to create the small lake. Then I created the ripples of the water and the waves with an acrylic gel. In my story, a pirate ship is approaching this mysterious Skull Island, so I started making a pirate ship from polymer clay. I used my file and my cutting knife to create the shape of the ship and added some details which I created with styrene. I painted the ship with acrylic colors. I used toothpicks to create the masts. And also used thin thread, thin wire, and small pieces which I cut from tea bags to create the rigging and the sails. I had to place the ship inside the water, so I used my Dremel to create a cavity and glued the ship inside the cavity with UV resin. Then I used again an acrylic gel to create the sea texture. At the final stages of this project, I used my router to create a wooden base. I used a thin brush and white acrylic color to paint the details on the water. And my diorama was finished. So this is the final result, my version of the Skull Island, the way I imagined it. It was a fun project to make, although to be frank the palm trees were indeed a pain, and I hope that you also enjoyed watching the process. Thank you very much for watching. If you liked the video, please hit the like button and leave me a comment below. If you are new to this channel, please consider subscribing. As always, I would like to say a huge thank you to my patrons and supporters. Have a great day, everyone, and I'll see you again next time. Goodbye.